Welcome back to DocTuber, myself Dr. Shivshankar Pal. I will be discussing about a new topic today, that is osteoporosis. If you have still not subscribed to our channel, please do subscribe and watch this video till the end. Now what is osteoporosis? Osteoporosis is a condition where the bones becomes brittle and weak. So in this diagram we can see that there is two types of bone, that is healthy bone and osteoporotic bone. Now in osteoporotic bone there is decrease in the mineral density. Now this is due to the fact that there is less deposition of calcium in the osteoporotic bone and increased resorption of the bone. Now in this diagram we can see that the bone mineral density of men is much more than women. Now at the age of 30 to 40 the bone mineral density gets at its peak, but after that, after the age of 50, the bone mineral density decreases. In men there is a slow decrease due to slow decline of androgen levels, while in female there is a rapid decrease due to the decreased production of estrogen from the ovaries. Now what happens if you are suffering from osteoporosis? Osteoporosis leads to the increased risk of fractures, especially in the regions of vertebra and in the regions of neck femur region. These regions are prone to fractures in old age. In this diagram we can see that there may be compression fracture of vertebra due to osteoporosis or neck femur fracture in hip due to osteoporosis. These two fractures are commonly found in osteoporotic patients. Now bone is comprised of mainly three cells: osteoblasts, which are responsible for formation of the bone, osteoclasts, which are responsible for resorption of the bone, and osteocytes, which are mature bone cells. Now let us know what hormones are responsible for increasing or decreasing bone mineral density. Now parathyroid hormone and vitamin D increases the osteoclastic activity, while calcitonin, androgen and estrogen decreases the osteoclastic activity. Also, corticosteroid like drugs inhibit the osteoblast, which decreases the bone density. And growth hormone and thyroid hormones increase the osteoclastic activity and thereby increases the bone mineral density. Now, other drugs which can be used to increase the bone density is biphosphonates. Now, these drugs are used under strict precaution and guidance of physician.
Now there are various risk factors for osteoporosis: vitamin D deficiency, calcium deficiency during pregnancy and in cases of malabsorption, magnesium, vitamin K2 and boron deficiency. Sex hormone deficiency during old age is a major risk factor. Increased alcohol consumption. Now soft drinks contains phosphoric acid which binds to calcium, which can decrease the bone calcium level. High animal protein diet is also acidic and can decrease the calcium in our bones. Now, decreased weight training exercises can weaken our bones. Now, coming to the diseases leading to osteoporosis. Celiac disease is caused due to gluten in our diet. Now, gluten is found in wheat and this disease causes malabsorption of calcium. Drug overuse like antacids, steroids, pioglitazone, lithium, warfarin, methotrexate, anti-epileptic drugs can lead to osteoporosis. Chronic kidney disease also leads to osteoporosis due to increased parathyroid hormone level. Endocrine disorders like Cushing syndrome, diabetes, genetic disorders and thyroid dysfunction can also lead to osteoporosis. Now osteoporosis is measured via DEXA scan. It uses X-ray to measure the density of the bones.
Now interpretation of DEXA scan is done via T-scores. Now when your T-score is above -1, you are normal, but below -1 to -2.5, you are osteopenic, and below -2.5, you are suffering from osteoporosis. Now, vitamin D is very much important for osteoporosis prevention. Now, the main source of vitamin D is sun, and we get limited amount from the diet. Now, when vitamin D level in our body gets reduced, there is decreased calcium absorption, which leads to increase of the parathyroid hormone, which increases the resorption of the calcium from the bones, leading to osteoporosis. Now, there is also weakness in muscles and this can lead to fractures.
Now, coming to calcium deficiency, our regular diet already contains good amount of calcium, and calcium deficiency can occur in cases of pregnancy, malabsorption or decreased vitamin D levels in our body. Now, regular intake of calcium supplements for a long time can be harmful for us, and it should be used very cautiously. So let's know why calcium supplements can be harmful for us. Now calcium supplements increase the serum calcium level, which complexes with pyrophosphate, which leads to arterial calcification and carotid plaque thickness. Also, calcium leads to increased blood coagulation. These events can lead to cardiovascular mortality, stroke, and heart attack. Now, in this graph, we can see that calcium supplementation is strongly correlated to aortic calcification. Apart from age, smoking, hypertension, and diabetes and overweight, calcium supplementation is the second leading cause of aortic calcification. Now, the coronary calcium score is done by CT angiogram. This records the amount of calcium present in the coronary arteries according to Eggleston scale. Now, this score can predict the future chances of heart attacks. Now, calcium supplementation increases the chances of stroke about 19% more. Also, it increases the chances of heart attack and kidney stone and gallstones also. Now, magnesium is very much important for preventing osteoporosis. Magnesium deficiency is caused due to decreased intake, decreased intestinal absorption, diabetes, alcohol mainly. Now, magnesium deficiency causes large hydroxyapatite crystals, which decreases the bone stiffness. Magnesium deficiency decreases the osteoblast formation and increases the osteoclast formation. Severe magnesium deficiency decreases the serum parathyroid hormone. It decreases the vitamin D production and also decreases the bone formation. Magnesium deficiency causes oxidative stress damage and inflammation. It increases the osteoclastic activity, thereby increasing the bone resorption. It also causes endothelial dysfunction and altered blood supply. Now, we have already discussed about magnesium and its benefits in our previous videos. To get the link of the magnesium supplement, click the I button above. Vitamin K2-MK7 is very much important for bone formation. Osteoblast releases a protein called osteocalcin in inactive form. It is converted into active form via vitamin K2-MK7. Now, this protein attaches calcium to it and it is deposited in the bones. So, vitamin K2-MK7 is very much important for bone formation. Vitamin K2-MK7 stimulates the osteoblasts and inhibits the osteoclasts. It also inhibits the nuclear factor kappa B responsible for cytokine production, and thus cytokines like TNF-alpha are not produced, which can inhibit the osteoblasts. Now, coming to the food sources of vitamin K2-MK7, it is found in limited number of foods like beef, yogurt, milk, hard cheese, egg yolk, and soft cheese. So, supplementation of vitamin K2 becomes important because it is not available in very many foods. Now, you can take vitamin K2-MK7 and vitamin D3 supplement from Herbal Leaf. Now, it is available online and you will get 7000 units of vitamin D3 and 100 mg of vitamin K2. You have to take one tablet daily after meals. You can purchase from the link given below. Now, boron is essential for growth and maintenance of bone. It beneficially impacts the body's use of estrogen, testosterone, and vitamin D. It boosts magnesium absorption and it decreases the inflammation. Now, in studies, it has been found that boron can increase the vitamin D level in our serum by 24% in a span of 60 days. Now, boron-rich foods include spinach, almonds, beans, pumpkin seeds, avocado, tomato, and raisins. Now, coming to calcium supplement. Now, in cases where you need a complete calcium supplement, you can take Osopan HD. It contains calcium carbonate, vitamin D3, magnesium, vitamin K2-MK7, manganese, and boron. It is a complete supplement and you can take it once daily after lunch. Now, calcitonin spray is also used in osteoporosis. The dose is 1 puff daily in alternate nostrils. It is found in the name of Jemitrol NS in any pharmacy stores. Now, it is quite expensive, but you can use it.
Thanks for watching our video. I hope you have liked our video. Please do like, share, and subscribe, and see you in next episode.